Hey everybody, Billy from LM Case's Custom Integration Department, and today we're going to take a look at a very, very cool case that we're calling the Comfort Case that we did for our friends at Paradise Productions. So this is an on-site, basically craft services case. Everything that's in there is a microwave, Keurig, Nespresso machine, refrigerator, printer, built-in wide area Wi-Fi router, and courtesy power to provide everything that the guys at Paradise Productions need for an install or for a long show site. So let's take a look at some of the features. Okay, so let's take a look and see how power comes into this case. So we have a 12U rack section for utility things in this particular case. We have 10U of that has this door that is removable. The benefit of the removable door is obviously if you need to work on anything in the rack, which if I must say so myself is very lovely in its neatness and wiring, you can, and then obviously you can leave it closed for the majority of this case's life. So the bottom 2U is exposed. So we do have a power distro here on the very bottom of the case that brings input power in, and you may be asking yourself, why does it say power distro on there? Seems a bit redundant, right? Well, that's there for troubleshooting. So because we have two essentially power modules in the case that split power up, if you're talking with somebody on the phone, if they're having any type of show problem for tech support, it differentiates the two modules. So what this does is it takes two independent circuits in, an A circuit and a B circuit, or if we're talking in phases X and Y, and brings it into the case so that if you're using this on normal wall power, 15 amp, 120 volt wall power, you can find two circuits so that you can split the two circuits up together so that, and when we take a look at the front of the case, we'll show you how that's split up so that the appliances are on one circuit and all the office equipment is on another. We do have two 20 amp hydraulic breakers that are back here. So this is a master breaker for the system, bringing power into the case. And one of the reasons why we have those are we provided a custom L2130 to 3 Edison breakout cable. Now, this is a custom cable that is designed for this case. This takes three phases and splits them up into X, Y, and Z so that if you do have show power available to you, you can have this split up off of a power distro beyond our regular wall power, so that's true to regular Edison. If you're looking at this cable, any electricians in the audience are saying this should be a twist lock connector. One of the reasons why we're not using that is we want to just have the same power cables for that, but as a safety feature, we do have 20 amp breakers so that if you do draw more than this particular plug is rated for, you're protecting that with the 20 amp breaker. So looking back on the back portion of the rack here, we do have our access point that's back here. We do have the Wi-Fi name and password so that if you are deploying this into a show site, if anybody wants to know what the password is, you can just take a look at the back of the rack. It's out of sight, but it's there. So taking a look at the wiring, every wire in this case is custom cut per length. So looking at all of the wiring, all of the lighting, the LED lighting is all in shielded cable. So that you're not going to get any interference if it's running adjacent to any either Ethernet line or power line. All of the appliance power cable is all wired with SJO cable. It's all custom cut. Every wire that's in here is labeled at both ends. So if we're looking at this particular wire as an example, this is the coffee maker, the fridge, the microwave. So if troubleshooting ever needs to happen, if something comes unplugged, if something's not working, the way that we wire things here at LM is that any objective person can look at the way that we have it wired and you can logically see what we're up to. Everything is very labeled, very neat. You can look in anything and see. We go into details just as far as like main cables as an example too. So like if you're looking at this red cable, we always make our WAN cables red so that you can find out what the main cable is for any system. So moving on to the front of the case here, we do have a little flush-mounted pop-up table so that if you do find that you need an extra bit of space for a coffee creamer or a printer or any type of laptop or anything there, you've got this courtesy table. So let's take a look at the front. All right. Now that this is plugged in, let's take a look to see how we power the system up. So on the back, we did have our two separate phases. We'll call it X and Y. But we also have a bank of a Z bank so that if you do want to have three-phase power, we have an option for that. So this is the nerve center for power. This takes our three phases, if we have three phases available, or two phases as it's currently wired, and shows us our available line voltage and also the amp draw. Now, the reason why we're doing this is one of the stipulations about this project was they needed to run this off normal wall power. So if show power wasn't available, they needed to plug it into just a regular Edison outlet that is, you know, 120 volts and 15 amps. So what we did was we went through and we calculated all of the draw of each one of the appliances. So say, for example, the printer here, that we have a little P-Touch label on here that says the printer draws 8 amps. So what this box right here does is it shows you how much amperage each of your phases are drawing. So you know that if you're printing something, maybe you can't make a cup of coffee, or maybe you can. So this is the second round of breakers. So on the back, remember we have two 20 amp breakers on that. We also have a separate 20 amp breaker for each one of our phases here. So let's power up the case. So right now, all of our breakers are in the off position. You can very clearly see that they're off by this nice white exposed part here. So actually, before we power that up, so this is the appliances on bank X, the office equipment on bank Y, and all of our courtesy outlets on bank Z. So let's power up bank X here. A very festive microwave. So you can see that we're now peaked at 18 amps as the refrigerator kicked on. And our coffee makers are now heating. So our line voltage down to 110. Now we're back up. Now we're reducing our amp draw. So let's turn our office equipment on. So this is going to turn the router on, which apologies for the fan noise, and our printer. And because bank Y and bank Z are patched together, that brought this screen online also. So we'll turn this on so our courtesy outlets work, which also brings our lighting on. So now we have a good monitor of what each of our segments in this case are drawing. Now, some of the reasons that might be important. Let's say, for example, you're taking this case to a trade show and you're paying for booth power and they just give you one 15 amp circuit because you don't want to pay for anything extra. Well, you can use this as your guide to say what you can use so that you don't overdraw the power that's allotted to you. So looking further into the case, let's take a look at our rack section here, since this is our nerve center. So, the 52278 box, we've done a video on that previously. If you'd like to check that out, just check the link in the upper corner of your screen and you can see more detail on that. The lighting is all controlled by this, which we're calling the DSK LMAB module. Say that three times fast. We also did a video on that, which you can check out by clicking the link in the top corner of the screen as well, if you'd like to see that in more detail. But basically, what this box does is it takes regular line power and it converts it to DC. So there is an adjustable DC power supply in here that goes from 9 volts to 13 volts that you can switch however you need. And it powers this very cool little light, task light, which is dimmable right there. And it also powers a bank of white lights and red lights. So right now the lights are lit white. We can change that to red so that if you're in a show mode, you don't lose your night vision. If this is hanging out in the wings of a show, you can go up to it and print or get anything that you need. And it's not going to be intrusive as far as lighting goes. And then also you're not going to lose your night vision if you're working backstage. So within the rack section, we're giving you a great deal of flexibility in terms of the power and networking. So power-wise, we have transformer isolated power strip up here that takes all of the office equipment and puts it on the other side of a transformer to keep it on the other side of anything that's a heating element. So, you know, obviously the microwave, the coffee makers are essentially big heaters. The refrigerator can kick on. So I just wanted to have something that would isolate all of that from any type of ground noise or any type of interference from that kicking on. We've also got another bank of courtesy outlets here on a separate phase. So this is on bank Y, this is on bank Z. So if you're running this in a three-phase configuration, you can get that. So this box has four different banks of Edison duplex outlets. So you have 8 courtesy Edisons on here. You also have 8 USB-A's for charging. And you also have 2 power cons on here, which you might be asking yourself, why do we have power cons on there? Well, we make these cool little 4-plex courtesy boxes, which you can buy separately, lmcasesonline.com. And you can plug this guy into here just like this, and you've got an additional 4-plex of outlets should you need them. If you don't, take it and put it away. Going down, we're using a Ubiquity edge router in this system. This has an access point on the back panel that's on a custom-built rack panel that's on the back. And one of the reasons why we spec'd this router is it allows you to take multiple WAN streams in and split it. So if this is a over-glorified version of your Linksys router. So if you're not hip with a network-grade router like this, it allows you to take multiple streams in. So if this case is providing show network, it can take multiple streams in so that this can act as itself, or it can distribute show network to various other sites. So that's this router. So you can take up to 5 individual WAN streams into this, which is just pretty cool. We've got an extra switch in here that gives you some extra outputs here. So there are an additional 4 courtesy LAN ports on the front here, so that if you're running an additional printer or you're running additional access point or anything like that, you can patch that in here without having to reach your hand in. WAN for the case, wire network, comes in over an Ethercon jack, so that if you are running an Ethercon tactical line, which I would suggest that you do, you can run that in right there. That'll also take a regular RJ45. The printer is also wired into the switch, which also hits the access point, obviously. So even if this case is not connected to an internet network or the internet, you can still find the Wi-Fi hotspot on your phone and print, which is a nice feature. If you want to hardwire to the printer, you can also. There's a USB that's mounted right here. You can just plug your computer in, and you can do it in that way, which brings us down to the printer compartment. We do have red LEDs on the side here. This is mounted on a slide-out shelf. There is a custom loom on the back that keeps all of the wiring extremely neat in one sheath, so that when you're pushing the printer in and out, there isn't anything that's going to get bound up. You can use the printer outside of the case. You can use it inside of the case. We've got custom CNC brackets that are on the sides here that contour the shape of the printer so that this is on here. It's not going to go anywhere. The foam in the lid is above this compartment is such that if this case bounces in the truck, this printer isn't going to come off of this compartment. So that's a really, really nice way of doing this that doesn't require any type of strapping or anything like that when this is in use. Going down, we've got 3 drawers that each have courtesy lighting in it. So when you're in a red light mode, that obviously illuminates red. If you put it in white, this other bank illuminates, and so that if you're going into a drawer in the dark of the backstage, you can see what's going on in there, which I think is really nice. And we've got three of these drawers. Half-inch Baltic birch, texture-coated, our normal heavy-duty Accuride glides. A very, very robust drawer. Going up to the microwave compartment. It's a microwave in a compartment. The coffee makers follow the same protocol as the printer in terms of the way we secure them to this work surface. They have custom CNC'd marine grade plastic pieces that hold them in place, so that again they're not gonna move. And one of the things that I do want to point out here is just some of the tolerances that we're working with. So come a little closer. As this slides in, you can see what we're up to here with our little K-cup compartment, and then again at the top. So when these are in here, there's a piece of foam that actually does contour where the Keurig starts, and it prevents it from sliding around. So this is a very, very robust thing. This is a piece that is designed to be on the road, and designed to live in the back of a truck. So we've got some courtesy K-cups here just to kind of show you that there's some coffee there. Fridge, this is nice stainless steel with a glass door, so you can see exactly what's in it. It's got an internal light, so you can see what's going on in there backstage, which is a nice blue light, so that, you know, it's not gonna kill your stage lighting or your night vision when you're on stage, which is super, super nice. So something to point out, this is at 34 degrees right now in max cooling. We just powered the case on, and it is drawing less than 1 amp. It's not even on the meter. So although we definitely did an overkill as far as metering goes on here, we've run all of this on at once with both of the coffee machines and the microwave running, and you can easily run it off of the normal a normal standard residential Edison line. So if you're wondering, can you use all of this at once? Yes. Should you? No. But you can. The front here, the front of the case does have pocket doors. So these come out just like this and slam into place. So at the end of the night, when you're either deploying this case or putting it away, it does pack up and put away really, really nice. So if you have any questions, you can email me direct, billy@lmcases.com. If you'd like more info on this case, see some still pictures, and just the narrative that we wrote up on each of the things, links and all that other kind of stuff, you can check this case out at lmcases.com. Thanks for stopping by.